Did you watch an NVIDIA ad? I mean, the patch preview on the Cyberpunk 2077 YouTube channel? The developers did a fantastic job going into a ton of detail about how NVIDIA would like you to think about, how CD Projekt leverages new technology to enhance your gaming experience. They went into so many technical details that they forgot to mention that the patch also ships Intel's XeSS upscaler and drastically improves performance on Intel Arc GPUs. The performance is so good now, I can give the A770 and A750 strong recommendation. Let's have a look. First, can the Intel Arc A770 run Cyberpunk with path tracing? Technically, yes, but practically, no. I ran the game at 1080p using XeSS performance mode and averaged around 20 FPS, which even a lot of console players wouldn't go out of their way to call smooth. XeSS has a lot of reconstructive surgery on the dismembered 540p base image. When we use AMD's upscaling technology, we can reach an even lower base resolution of 360p by enabling the ultra performance mode. The result looks horrid. I point this out because the people who played the game on PS4 when it was released would otherwise assume that's how the game's supposed to look. In this patch, I saw a huge performance bump on my A770. In previous videos, I mentioned that Cyberpunk didn't seem to run as well as it should on Arc. But that issue seems to be resolved entirely. I don't know what did the trick, but it's all good now. I didn't test on a slower CPU this time, but on this 5800X3D, performance is flawless on high crowd density. At 1080p, I got about 15 FPS improvement over the benchmark using the latest Cyberpunk patch, that's 1.62, and Intel driver 4255 compared to the previous version of the game and driver that I used in my earlier Arc video. Path tracing may not be a good idea on Intel graphics cards for now, but the game is playable on the medium ray tracing setting. It's good enough to run it on a slower paced, stealthy playthrough. But for a faster paced character build, I wouldn't use ray tracing. I use something between high and ultra settings. Using the high preset at 1080p and no upscaling, we can hit between 75 and 90 FPS night city. At 1080p, XeSS Ultra Quality Mode looks fine, but the quality mode was noticeably lower fidelity. I recommend not using upscaling or the Ultra Quality Mode on a 1080p monitor because the loss in visual fidelity is not worth the increased frame rate. I consider 1440p the perfect resolution for the A770, and the card didn't disappoint. Again, I used the high preset without chromatic aberration and fill grain, of course, and enabled the Intel XeSS quality mode. The quality mode looks perfectly acceptable to me at 1440p, and the frame rate was between 65 and 75. CD Projekt and Nvidia shipped a genuinely cool feature currently in a tech demo state, but it will be interesting to see how it performs on future hardware. I was impressed by the uplifting performance on the Intel Arc graphics card and glad to see the inclusion of XeSS. We've explored some problems in previous videos, but Arc is moving in the right direction. If you want to see how modern games that aren't Cyberpunk run on the Intel Arc, check out this fully voiced 60 games test reel. If you are into old games, this may interest you. But either way, you can give yourself and others a better chance of being presented in my next video by the almighty YouTube algorithm by subscribing, liking, commenting, and sharing.